the pandemic created instability in the market and created a lot of financial issues globally with infrastructure projects. We see a massive push and interest from governments to cooling technologies to reduce the spending on cooling, bring a massive saving in terms of electricity consumption when compared to conventional cooling. District cooling is a tool for economies to minimize their costs, so it has a positive impact on the private sector participation. And I believe in 2023, this participation will increase, where the private sector in Saudi specifically, we are working to provide district cooling services projects such as King Salman Park and the Red Sea. The idea is to improve the efficiencies of these cities and to bring more sustainable and environmentally friendly solutions to these projects. Saudi Arabia is one of the largest producers of electricity in the world, and the majority of it is being produced through consumption of fossil fuels. To give you a perspective in numbers, Saudi Arabia consumes 70% of the electricity it generates for cooling purposes. District cooling reduces electricity consumption by roughly 50% when compared to conventional cooling, hence substantially reducing fossil fuels usage and enabling Saudi and the wider Middle East region in general to achieve its green initiative. This reduces carbon emissions. We are working internally to calculate all the requirements project by project and to make sure that we are within the limits. We are also introducing renewable energies to our projects. All of these things will enhance the ESG capability, which will reflect on the country itself. The core success of public-private participation is the bankability of the concession framework. Project financing structure also allows all the parties to structure the deal in a proper bankable manner. In the last 17 years, Saudi Tabreed has built a very strong relationship with lenders and internationally and locally, and the idea is to improve district cooling in Saudi Arabia. The region accepts the benefits that district cooling brings to the industry and to the countries. However, one of the major barriers is regulating the sector. Private sector participation regulation is very important, specifically within the residential usage area, which we are pushing the stakeholders for. Secondly, district cooling PPP risk allocation should be made similar to other infrastructure assets, where private sector participation is extensive to ensure the district cooling developers and the lending communities. Since we are pioneer in this industry, so this can be transferred outside of the region itself. We can go to Africa, we can go to other countries to transfer the knowledge and the know-how. This reduces the carbon emissions. We have the technology, we have the capability, so we are ready for this.